I sit here in my recliner and I just think these are not easy words. These are, toe-stepping words, but there's something that has to be said. I don't know who this is for tonight, but it's just really heavy on my heart. I'm sitting here, it's quiet. I've got time to just think and reflect. And I found myself in Psalms 99. I want to read to you in just a moment, but I find myself, I'm just perplexed. I can't understand how so many of us who claim to be Christians are just satisfied with sitting and soaking and just souring instead of, we're supposed to sit and soak and serve. We're supposed to go out and be the hands and feet of Jesus. We're not supposed to just sit and soak up and soak up and soak up and just sit there and sour. That's not what God's called us to do. He's called us to act. He's called us to live out His word and to carry out His commandments. That's what we're called to do, not to just sit there and take all this in for ourselves. That's not what it's about. I think so many times we forget who we serve. We think we serve this, little wimpy God that we can just hold in the palm of our hand, and He's our genie in a bottle, and we just rub and rub and go to Him when we're in need. That's not the God that we serve. Yes, He's a God who meets our needs. Yes, He's a God who gives us healing. Yes, He's all these things. But we serve an awesome God. We serve a God who's holy, a God that's set apart, who's different than this little God that we just put in our back pocket. I want to read to you guys some words from Psalms 99. The Lord reigns, let the nations tremble. He sits enthroned between the cherubim. That's angels. He sits between the angels. Let the earth shake. Great is the Lord in Zion. He is exalted over all the nations. Let them praise your great and awesome name. He is holy. The king is mighty. He loves justice. You have established equity. In Jacob, you have done what is right and just. Exalt the Lord our God and worship at his footstool. He is holy. Moses and Aaron were among his priests. Samuel was among those who called on his name. They called on the Lord and he answered them. He spoke to them from the pillar of the cloud. They kept his statutes and he gave them the decrees of life. O Lord our God, you answered them to Israel, a forgiving God, though you punished their misdeeds. Exalt the Lord our God and worship at his holy mountain, for the Lord our God is holy. It says over and over in that scripture, the Lord our God is holy, that we're to tremble at his presence. He is a mighty God. He is a powerful God. He is an all-knowing, just all-present God, yet He wants to talk to us. He wants to hear from us. He answered them, the Israelites, when they were going on this 40-year journey to the Promised Land. When they were going on this journey, God was there with them, and He was in that pillar of cloud, that pillar of fire, and He spoke to them. He heard them. He heard their cries. He answered them because they were His people. If you are a child of God, you are His. You are in the palm of His hand, and we've got to start living like we understand that we are heirs to the throne, that we are sons and daughters of the King, of the Most High God. Instead of allowing ourselves to just sit and soak and sour, we have got to claim this thing. We've got to walk it out. We've got to learn what His word says about us, and that who He says we are, and what He says we can do through Christ who strengthens us. We are not these little weak and puny just pawns that the enemy can just flick out of the way. We are heirs to the Most High God. We are sons and daughters. We are ambassadors of God. We've got to walk in that. We've got to walk like it and act like it. We've got to know who we are in Christ. Because if we don't know who we are, who are we portraying? How do we reflect something that we don't even have a clue who we are? If we can't take it, just grasp hold of who God has called us to be, how are we going to make a difference in this life? How in the world are we going to know what we're called to do if we can't grasp that? I just want to encourage you tonight to realize that God, he's not this little, pocket God. He's not this little idol. He's not just a something to check off your to-do list on Sundays and Wednesdays. He wants a living, breathing relationship with you and all the mess that you've created, you and all the mess that you are, me and all my mess. He wants a relationship with us, and He wants us to understand who we are, that we are children of the Most High God. Walk in that. And walk in that, be encouraged, smile, act like you have some joy, be joyful and walk in that joy, because He has called it the joy, restoring to us the joy of our salvation. It says in the Word of God that maybe we just need our joy restored. Maybe we just need a little bit of that reminder of where God brought us from to keep us humble, because I know where God brought me from. He brought me down, brought me from the pit. He reached down, way down, and reached down to pick up a hypocrite like me years ago. And I can't see living less for Him. We've got to live just I don't even know how to explain it. I mean, if we could grasp who God is and how holy He is, set apart, He is righteous, He is powerful, omnipotent, He created the universe, yet He wants something to do with you and me in all of our mess. He wants something to do with us. That's something to shout about. That's something to be excited about. We're supposed to praise Him. It says in the Word that the rocks will cry out in our place if we're silent. I refuse to let a rock cry out in my place. I pray that you do the same, that you just start crying out to God and worshiping Him in spirit and in truth, and that you just wrap your mind around what He's done for you and what He's calling you to do. Don't be afraid. Walk this thing out. Whatever He's called you to do, the passions that He's put in your heart, go for it. Claim it. Claim that land that your feet are stepping on right now, because God's called you to do great and awesome things. But we've got to understand who we are in Christ, and that we are heirs to the throne, and that we are sons and daughters of the Most High God. Live Life Unscripted today. If you're encouraged, please check out my blog, lifeunscriptedministries.org, Life Unscripted Ministries 5. You can find me on Twitter and Facebook at that. I love you guys. I'm praying for you guys. Walk this thing out. Realize who you are in Christ. Love you guys.